Very good morning, students. I hope that you are doing well. I think you have written yesterday exam very well, right? If you have any doubts, please post to me. I'll be solving the questions and I'll be sending the answers to you. Okay, now coming into the topic. Today we are going to start a new chapter which is called as equilibrium. In equilibrium, you have two parts. One is chemical equilibrium and another part is acids and bases. Right, those are the parts of equilibrium only. Right, first we will be going regarding the chemical equilibrium. In the next session, in the next week, we will be going with respect to acids and bases. So this is the syllabus for you this weekend. Chemical equilibrium is entire chapter. Right, see here, if you see with respect to physics, a particle is placed on the floor and you are applying 5 newton's force from this side and 5 newton's force from this side also. What happens? Will the body will move? No, the body will be in the rest condition. So equal forces are acting in opposite direction. This type of equilibrium means, what is mean by equilibrium? Means it is equal in conditions. If it is equal in conditions from both the sides, okay, from both the sides, then that is called as equilibrium. If you see in terms of this particle, this is called as static equilibrium. And if you see, let us take one more example like this one. You are taking a beaker, you are filling, already it has been filled with water. Now you are opening a tap. There are coming 10 drops per second. Assume that 10 drops per second. And there is a hole at the bottom of the beaker and the leaving is 10 drops per second. Right? See, the number of drops coming from the tap is 10 drops per second and the number of drops that are leaving the container is also 10 drops per the second. So what happens now? Will the water level will be increased or decreased? The water level remains same. Okay, the water level in the beaker remains same as the number of drops entering into the beaker and the number of drops leaving the beaker are the same. So the water level remains same. This type of equilibrium, it is called as dynamic equilibrium. So this is not in resting condition. Continuously it is coming, continuously it is going. But how much it is coming, that much it is leaving. So we will be calling this type of equilibrium. It is called as dynamic equilibrium. Please be clear with this. This one opposite force it is acting. The particle is not at all moving. That is called as static equilibrium. If the number of particles coming and the number of particles are going are the same, this one appears to be like equilibrium. It is in rest condition. It will be appearing like that. But actually the number of drops are coming and the number of drops are leaving. So this type of equilibrium, it is called as dynamic equilibrium. So in dynamic equilibrium, we can say this as, it is coming forward. Assume this one, it is backward. Okay. So forward reaction speed, it is also equal to backward reaction speed in chemical equilibrium. This one is the major point. Forward reaction speed will be equal to the backward reaction speed. And speed can be called with one more term in chemistry. That is called as, what students? Rate. Where you have learned this? Graham's law of diffusion of gases. There the speed is called as rate. In chemistry, everywhere if speed is present, then that is called as rate. So instead of forward reaction speed, we can call it as rate of forward reaction should be equal to the rate of backward reaction. Okay. And first you remember, chemical equilibrium is dynamic in nature, okay, and it is not static, okay students. Now if you go for the types of the reactions, if you see the reactions, how many types of reactions are there? Means chemical reaction in this chapter we can basically classify into two types. One is reversible reaction and one is irreversible reaction. See, let us go for the reversible reaction. In reversible reaction, okay, assume that there are reactants A plus B. It is getting converted into the products C plus D. Okay, reactants are getting converted into the products. Right, if initial time, at starting time I have taken 2 moles and B also I have taken 2 moles. If reactants only are present at the starting time, you will not be having products. Okay, this will be trying to get converted into the products so that you are having 0 products. After some time, what happens? After some time T, the reactants will be getting converted into the products. That is something like one mole, assume that here how much it will be left out, one mole, okay. After the formation of the product also tries to get convert into the reactant. So what happens? Reactants are getting converted into products, products are getting converted into the reactants. Whenever this type of conditions is existing, okay, then those type of reactions are called as reversible reactions. If the reactant is getting converted only into product, here there is reactant, it is getting into product, and the product is not getting into the converting into the reactant, then that type of reactions are called as irreversible reactions, right? Chemical reactions in which the product is not converted into the reactant, those are called as irreversible reactant. So at the starting time, if you take the reactant, what happens? As the reactant will be present and the product will be zero. As the time goes on increasing, at starting time reactant only will be present, after that product will be zero. If the time is going on increasing, what happens to the concentration of the reactant with respect to time? It goes on decreasing. And with respect to time, what happens to the concentration of the product? It goes on increasing. At one stage, this one will become zero and this one will become completely product and no reactant will be present. And this type of reactant, where only the product is formed and the product is not getting converted into the reactant, then that type of reactant, that type of reactions are called as irreversible reactions. Right, students? If you take example for reversible reactions, so N2 plus 3H2, it is giving rise to 2NH3. SO2 plus O2 giving rise to SO3, and SO3 also getting converted into SO2 plus O2. The same way, PCl5 converting to PCl3 plus Cl2, and products also getting converted into reactants. H2 plus I2 converting into 2HI, and in the same way, HI converting to reactants. 2NO plus 2NO gives rise to N2 plus O2, in the same way, it is getting converted into the reactants. Suppose if you see the examples for the irreversible reactions. So something like A plus B converts to C plus D. Examples are something like neutralization reactions. What is meant by neutralization reactions? Means acid plus base, they react and they form salt plus water. Such type of reactions are called as neutralization reactions. Okay. So I am taking HCl acid, NaOH base, these two are reacting so that NaCl is formed and water is also formed. Such type of reactions are called as neutralization reactions. One more type of examples like precipitation reactions. Precipitation means there will be settling of one chemical at the bottom of the beaker. Suppose if you take AgNO3 and NaCl, if you mix these two, you will be getting AgCl precipitated and Na3 will be floating. This will be like a liquid condition and this will be like a precipitate. It will be settling like a mud. If you mix water and mud, what happens? Mud gets settled at the bottom of the beaker, right? In the same way, AgCl gets settled at the bottom of the beaker. So all precipitation reactions are irreversible reactions. All neutralization reactions are irreversible reactions. And combustion reactions means carbon, it is reacting with oxygen, it forms carbon dioxide and some amount of heat is liberated, so that heat escapes. See here, and heat will not mix with this one and they will not form C plus O2. In the same way, you will take rice and you will cook by taking heat. What happens? It gets converted into food, right? If you cool the food, will it get converted into rice? No way. So such type of reactions are called as irreversible reactions. So chemical reactions can be characterized into two types. One is reversible, where the products gets converted into reactant and reactant gets converted into the product. Both interconvertible and they will be going on in the entire reaction. And if you go for the chemical reaction with respect to irreversible reaction, only the reactant will be getting converted into the product, whereas the product will not be getting converted into the reactant. This is only one direction, right? And this is bidirectional. Okay, and in this chapter, we will not at all, there is no importance of irreversible reactions. See, automatically it will be going. Where is the equilibrium in irreversible reactions? We will be having equilibrium only with respect to reversible reactions. So, entire chapter deals with only reversible reaction. Okay, students, see, and you notice here, at equilibrium, the rate of forward reaction, means how much fastly it is moving, the same rate should be backward. Okay. See, simply we can call it as rate of forward reaction should be equal to the rate of backward reaction. Okay, students? And chemical equilibrium is studied only for the reversible reaction, already we have mentioned. See, let us take one more point. Initially, reaction goes with greater speed. Means we will be having only reactants, so that what happens? The reaction will be going very fastly. As the time is going on increasing, what happens to the speed? The speed goes on decreasing, slows down, because the number of reactant molecules are getting decreased. At initial time, what will be the rate of backward reaction? It will be zero because there is no product at all. as the time is going on increasing, what happens? See, as the time is going on increasing, what happens? The product's concentration will be increased. Initially, reactant is present. Product is not present. So, the rate of forward reaction means reactant getting converted into the product. Means it is moving in the left to right direction, right? So, that is taken as forward reaction. That is moving very fastly. Because more concentration of reactant is present at the starting time. As the time is going on increasing, the number of reactant molecules are going on decreasing. So, what happens? The rate decreases. If you see with respect to products, so as at initial time, there are no products. So, at an initial time, what is the rate of the reaction? Rate of the reaction will be zero. As the time is going on, increasing, the rate of the reaction with respect to products, what happens? It goes on increasing. Why it goes on increasing? Because the number of products are going on increasing. See, starting reactants are going on decreasing. Products are going on increasing. At one point, okay, at one point, rate of this one will be equal to the rate of this one. Means rate of the reactants will be equal to the rate of the products at one particular point. That particular point, it is called as equilibrium point. See, initially concentration of reactants are very high. As the time is going on, the reactants concentration goes on decreases, so the rate decreases. Initially, the concentration of the products is zero, so the rate of the reaction for the products at the starting time is zero. As the time is going on increasing, the concentration of the products goes on increasing. What happens to the rate? The rate goes on increasing for the products with respect to time. At one particular point, the rate of the forward reaction will be equal to the rate of the backward reaction. That point is called as equilibrium point. At that point, both concentrations will be constant, not equal. Remember this. At equilibrium point, the concentration will be constant. See, again I am repeating, at equilibrium point, the concentration of the reactants and the products will be constant, right? Whereas the rate will be equal. Rate of forward reaction should be equal to the rate of backward reaction. Okay, students, let us take one example and solve whatever we have learned till now. So, if I take a graph here, so this is with respect to reactant. If I take this one is reactant and this is product. See, initially the rate is very high. At this starting time is zero. At zero time it is very high. Time is increasing. What is happening? It has been decreased. Time is increasing. It has been decreased. Time is increasing. It has been decreased. So at one point it comes a parallel line. So with respect to products, at starting time what is the speed? It is very low. As the time is increasing, products getting high. Rate of product is increasing. Rate of product is increasing. At one particular point, what has happened? The rate of forward reaction has been equal to rate of backward reaction. See, at this point, okay, means at this time, you are getting rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. See, rate should be equal. Okay, and if you know with respect to concentration, so initially rate of concentration of nitrogen is very high. As that time is, see, initially it is time zero, it is very high. Time is increasing, it has been decreased. Time is increasing, it has been decreased. And it has become constant after some time. Hydrogen, same. It has been this much. As time is increasing, it is going on decreasing. After some time, it has become constant. This is with respect to these two are reactants. And if you go with respect to this one, this is product. Initially, that at time, concentration is very zero. You doesn't have any, at time zero, you doesn't have any concentration of the product. As the time is increasing, what happens to the concentration? It goes on increasing. Okay, at one particular point, the concentration becomes constant. See, these may not be equal, but concentration, whatever that is present at the equilibrium point, it is constant, it will not change. But the rate should be equal. Getting this? Concentration should be constant, whatever that is present at the equilibrium point. And the rate should be equal, concentration is not equal. Whatever the concentration of the reactant, that should be the concentration of the product, that is not the condition. See, let me take one example now. See, N2 plus 3H2. Initially, I am taking this one 10. Initially, I am taking H2 as 40 particles. So, initially, what will be the concentration of this one? Zero. As the time is increasing, what happens? This one will decrease, right? So, let me take 3 molecules have been remained from 10. Here, something like 9 molecules have been remained. Let me assume that here, 6 particles has been remained. Okay. You have attained equilibrium. This is not equilibrium point. This is moving in this direction. So, as these are the particles, it is moving in the forward direction. At equilibrium point, N2 is 3, 3H2 is 9, and NH3 is 6. Whatever time you see, these particles will be the same. 3, 9, 6 will be same. It will not change. See, are they equal now? No. At whatever time you see, it will be 6. At whatever time you see, whenever after attaining the equilibrium, whenever you see 9, NH3, it will be 6. H2 will be 9 and N2 will be 3. At equilibrium point, this will be the condition. Okay, these are not equal, but this is there, no, this is moving in the forward direction. This rate of forward reaction and this rate of backward reaction is constant or equal. So rate of forward, this one converting into product is rate of forward reaction, this one converting into backside reactant, this is backward reaction. These two should be equal. If these two are equal, so that what happens, you will be maintaining all these things constant, but concentration is not constant. I hope that you are clear with this point. See, at equilibrium point, concentration is constant. At equilibrium point, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. Rate should be equal, concentration should be constant. Right, students? Let us solve with respect to grasp these two conditions. I am giving a question here. This is option A, this is option B, and this is option C. Right? The question is, which among the given is or are correct? In this, maybe one or more than one are correct. See, among these three, this is the question. Rate versus time. What happens? Reactant is going on decreasing with respect to time. Product is going on with respect to time. At one point, it has become equal. Right? So, this is correct. Rate with respect to time. Now here, rate with respect to time. What is happening to the reactant? It has decreased. And this one with respect to time, it has been increased. At one particular point, this point, what has happened? Rate of forward will be equal to rate of backward reaction. Well, at this point, after that, what is happening? Again, products is getting increased with the time. Again, with respect to reactants, it is getting with respect to time. What is happening? Is it maintaining equilibrium? No. So, what is generally rate? Rate should be equal. So, what happened after this? The concentration of the products is increased. If they are increasing, how they can be constant concentration on both sides? They will not be possible. So, rate should be equal to maintain the equilibrium. So, this one will not be the correct answer. Okay, at this point, it is okay. But after that, what is happening? This is not maintaining equal rate. So, this can't be the answer. And this one, see, this one, it is going on decreasing. It has become maintained constant. It has been maintained constant. Here, automatically, product's concentration is higher. See, this is reactant. Okay, this is reactant concentration is higher with respect to the product. Okay, again, there may be rate. Okay, those are not equal. So students, what will be the correct answer here now? So option A will be the correct answer. So same question, which among the following is or are correct for this question? Concentration with respect to time and this one as well as this one. Okay, see, concentration of the reactant is going on what? Decreasing, it has become constant. Now it has been going on increasing, it has become constant. What is the condition for concentration with respect to time? It should be constant. So concentration of reactant from this point, it has become constant. Same with respect to product also. So with respect to time, concentration has become constant. Now, so this is correct. Concentration with respect to time. What is condition? It should be constant. There is no condition that they should be equal. If they are equal also, nothing happens. So it has become up to here, concentration, this one. Concentration this one, it has become again equal. So this is also correct. What is condition now? It is going on like this. At this point, the concentration of the reactant is constant. The concentration of the product, it is becoming constant. So this one also with respect to constant, it is equal. So answers will be A, B, C. Again, I am repeating the point. Concentration of the reactant should be constant. See, concentration of the reactant should be constant at equilibrium point. But the rate at the equilibrium point should be equal. Means the rate of forward reaction should be equal to the rate of backward reaction. See students, if you have any doubt, once again you recap all the video. I will be stopping this one at this point and I will be continuing the next one in the next lecture. Thank you.